that. Now, coming back to you, Mr. Wani, you know, every other day, almost every other day, and it's so really sad to say this, but shutdowns are being observed in occupied Indian territory, of course, you know. And there are mobile internet services are suspended, you know, transport services are suspended. People are kidnapped and murdered without being questioned, all to deter the resolve of the Kashmiri people, so that maybe one day when they wake up, they're so tired of fighting, they don't even want to fight anymore. But we don't see that happening, which is absolutely great. The confidence and the courage is absolutely stunning. But in the near future, I really hope that does not happen. But that is the strategy of the enemy, right? So where are we going with this?
So the enemy has been trying it since last 70 years.
More importantly,
from last 30 years, we have seen the militarized repression of the Indian force in Kashmir. And unfortunately, there was no media, there was no social media at that time, no electronic media. People all over the world could know what's happening in Kashmir, because India had a curtain wall, iron wall on Kashmir, and nobody was allowed, even these days, when there is no boundaries for the media and other things. The international media is not allowed to go to Kashmir to cover Kashmir. International human rights organizations are not allowed to go there. India tried its every bit to make people of Kashmir under submission, and so that they should give up their struggle for rights of nation. But as they increased their militarized repression, there was more and more aggressive nature of response from the people of Kashmir, from each and every section of society of Kashmir.
Right.
And you can see from, if we go to the past, year 2018, it was the deadliest year in the past decade in Kashmir. 160 people who have killed, extrajudicial
killings. Yes, of course. Killing.
And among them, 31 were children below the age of 15.
And nobody was questioned even.
And 18 were women. 18 were women of them. And the pallets which were used from 2010 onwards and massively used during the protest in 2016 after the martyrdom of Burhan Wani, which has caused hundreds of thousands of people disabilities and mass blinding took place, which the New York Times said the year of dead eyes in Kashmir, as it was there. So these things are happening in Kashmir, but at the same time, you said that every day, during the year 2018, it has been there was 108 incidents of when internet was shut down in Kashmir. So in order that the information should not go out, the only purpose of shutting down the internet and social media sites is that the information should not go to, go to the international world.
But you know, but that is also sort of hoodwinking the international community.
That is hoodwinking the international community. India has been trying to do so. But despite of all that, what India has been doing, what India has been trying to hide, you saw that 2018 was an important year for the people of Kashmir in many respects. One, unfortunate that it was the deadliest year in the Kashmir. But more importantly, after 59 years, we had a report from the United Nations High Commissioner, the highest office in the United Nations responsible for the promotion and protection of human rights. The report has catalogued the, all the human rights violations that Indian occupation forces are committing in Indian-occupied Kashmir, be it arbitrary detention, be it enforced disappearance, be it sexual violence, be it the restriction on freedom of expression, opinion, restriction on the religious rights, and all that. So all these infringement on justice, and these are documented in that, well documented by the highest office.
This was
the first time. And the response from the Indian state, they're always,
still
it was that, is it fallacious, it is malicious, it was written in a comfort zone and all that. But you see, the, for the first time, the United Nations High Commissioner, he came with another statement in support of his report, and not only the High Commissioner, the United Nations Secretary General came with the support, said that whatever the report has been documented by the High Commissioner is the voice of UN. So it is now responsibility of the UN, the 193 United Nations membership. It is their responsibility, because the Secretary General has owned this report. So it was expected that after this report, India will feel some shame. Because after that, we in the European Parliament, in the British Parliament, there was a resolution and a report passed by, they also issued a report and confirming the report of the Human Rights Commissioner's Office, and also asking India to give them access to the air. And similarly, there was another report from the Independent Permanent Human Rights Commission of OIC. They had a report. They had also documented the human rights violation in Kashmir.
Right.
Very analytically, they had given the whole details of that. They were not also allowed to visit to the Indian occupied Kashmir.
Right.
And now the European Parliament also holds a debate on the human rights situation in Kashmir.
Yes.
So these are the things which are happening. So people, despite India's all efforts, that the world should remain silent on it, world should not know what is happening in Kashmir, the world is now
getting to know.
The world is showing its concerns. But what we see that these concerns are not enough.
But you know, that's right. We have to get back to the UNHCR report over here as well. But before that, we're heading out to a short break.